Beechworth Bakery has been a part of regional Victoria for three decades. And to celebrate the 30th year, it was decided there needed to be something a little different, something that could incorporate all six locations into one event. Beechworth Bakery's managing director, Marty Mattasoni, thought a bike ride might be a good idea, but not just a simple day ride. A ride that would cover 655 kilometres and visit all six of the bakery locations. Together with a team of people, including Michael and Nathan from Gruppo Sportivo, the idea was born. Welcome to the Tour De Beechworth Bakery. Based on the logistics and locations of the bakery, it was decided the tour would begin in picturesque Hillsville. Located around 65 kilometres east of Melbourne in the world-famous Yarra Valley region, it would be the perfect start point, allowing riders to then take a clockwise route to all of the bakeries, with a final ride across the finish line into Beechworth in the state's northeast some 5 days later. This would be a bike tour delivered on a professional level with accommodation, full catering and full support provided for the whole event, but with the added drive of raising funds for the Victorian State Emergency Service, commonly known as the SES. This also brings the added advantage of the SES providing full road safety support throughout the entire event. And of course, it will be a chance for the SES to gain a bit of extra profile through a range of charity events to be held throughout the tour. The afternoon before the official start day sees all the registered event riders, support crew and all associated people meeting at a hotel in Hillsville for a pre-ride brief and a chance to get to meet and know each other before tomorrow's big day.
It's our inaugural event and we'll see how it all ends up, but we should all have a can of beer, if you like to have a beer, to drink a toast with me. The ride's just come about purely by an idea about 6 or 7 years ago that I wanted to ride around all the bakeries.
Of course, there's also the first of the charity dinners, followed by a fundraising auction. With an early start on day one, the riders all take the short warm-up ride to the Beechworth Bakery in the heart of Hillsville for a substantial breakfast, a last-minute chance to check everything, and of course, to prepare for the day's 170-kilometre ride ahead. The weather, although expected to be fine and sunny, has thrown up a hot, windy day, with the mercury expected to reach the mid-30s. So the challenge starts right here. The ride out of Hillsville is easy, but within a few short kilometres, there's a chance to get the heart rate up and the leg muscles pumping with the first of the hills.
Starting to warm up a bit now.
Yeah, a few challenges, a few knees burning, they tell us.
Yeah,
a few legs burning.
I think that was only about an 8 or 9% climb.
Yeah.
Although descending afterwards is always a fun part.
Good 20k in. We'll see how we are at 150.
I don't want to say it's jacuzzi yet, but talk to me at the end.
Don't speak too soon.
Great start. Yep.
Fast downhill.
Yeah, it's nice, nice and easy downhill.
There was always going to be a ride through the outer suburbs of Melbourne, which was always unavoidable. But with the support of the SES and lots of red and blue flashing lights, it was done safely and at a good steady pace. Stopping for the first feed station was a welcome sight. Having just managed city traffic and with the temperature building, it's a great time to take on plenty of fluids.
Oh, just had a power red, quite like power red. Do you like power red?
The tour heads west towards the first day's target of Ballarat. The pace is already strong, the riders are all enthusiastic, and the hills are posing no problems. A welcome lunch stop gave another chance to regroup, refresh and recheck equipment before heading to one of the biggest climbs on the tour.
Whose stupid idea was this?
Okay, drivers to their vehicles.
To avoid the main highway and purely for safety reasons, the ride had to take in a 9 kilometre stretch of gravel road. Not ideal, but certainly a lot safer than a busy national highway.
Smelly, dirty,
Arrival into town and at the Beechworth Bakery Ballarat was a welcome relief for many, as it's been a hard and challenging day, with heat, gravel roads and big hills. But everyone's here and keen to ride the next day. Arriving at the hotel, their luggage is ready to be collected. The riders and support staff now have the opportunity to get into the comfortable accommodation, take a shower and put on some clean clothes. The evening sees a more relaxed time, with a chance to share stories of the day and get to know each other over dinner, also seeing new friendships grow.
Yeah, it was a really tough day, but in saying that, it was so satisfying.
Everyone seems to be having a good time and it's been really good.
Best part of today for me was when we met the local SES crew, and they had these two brand spanking new motorbikes, dirt bikes, that they'd never used before. So this was their inaugural run of these bikes. So we all congregated together in these two motorbikes, led us into town. And to me, it was a really emotional time. It was cool. You could see these SES guys. They just love these motorbikes and they'd never used them before. Like, you know, I think the SES has been a great partner for this tour. I don't think I'd choose anybody else.
Day two sees the tour group start the day with a substantial breakfast at Beechworth Bakery Ballarat and after a good night's sleep. Today's expected to offer great riding conditions with temperatures well below those of yesterday. Today, the tour is heading north through the central goldfields to the city of Bendigo, with a ride distance of 115 kilometres. Mostly flat roads, with just the odd climb here and there, just to keep the ride interesting. Of course, it wouldn't be the Tour De Beechworth Bakery if it didn't involve an SES escort out of town. The local Ballarat Brigade join in nice and early to get the day off to a rolling start. But not before the riders get a chance to stock up on snacks and sustenance and take precautions against the sun for the day. The final day's planning is confirmed, and then it's time to saddle up and get going. As always, the ride through Ballarat City traffic is made safe with the support of the SES. With around 30 kilometres ridden, it's time to regroup and take a break, but not without a puncture repair and checking tyre pressures. Riding through picturesque country Victoria, it's mostly flat, and the tour group are making great progress. Heading through Smeaton in central Victoria, it's hard to absorb that Smeaton in colonial times was once home to 7 hotels, 2 bakeries, 2 banks and various shops. Now only the Smeaton Hotel, known as the Cumberland, remains the shopping area, providing locals and travellers alike a cold drink and a warm meal. After a quick feed stop and the chance to take a few happy snaps, the group don't want to miss the opportunity to pick up a bit of speed wherever possible. Or maybe get a bit of a break with some drafting. All in the name of fun, of course. The lunch stop is at Newstead. Although it's not quite as hot as yesterday, it's still fairly warm. Taking on plenty of fluids is essential. It's also a chance to connect with absent loved ones and reapply sunscreen, ready for the last 50-kilometre stretch into Bendigo. Progress today has been quick, although everybody has been riding at their own pace. Arriving at the outskirts of Bendigo, it's time for the tour to regroup, ready to make the ride into Bendigo. Again with an SES escort, the tour rides into town with plenty of interested onlookers, and of course, the obligatory ride to the Beechworth Bakery. Although this time it's straight past to meet with more of the SES team, refuel and meet with the local newspaper near the Chinese Gardens. The evening has the tour group attending an SES fundraiser at the local basketball stadium, where it's a great chance to catch up on the day's events, but also raise some more money. It's also an opportunity for Marty Mattasoni to have a bit of a chat with the crowd and say a few thank yous. The evening was a great success, but as expected, it was an early finish, ready for the following day's ride.
Look, I think one of the things that makes this ride really unique is that it's five consecutive rides. There's a lot of single day rides, but unless you go overseas, there's not many rides here where you're going every day. I think that makes it really unique. It's certainly really friendly, and you get to cover so much of Victoria.
I'm not really a rider that rides a lot, but I've found it pretty easy because, you know, everybody helps you in the ride. So you're never alone, you know, there's always a car with you and whatever. And it's just been a fantastic event so far, and I'm sure it'll be great to the end.
Everything's taken care of for you. You don't have to do anything. No, you don't have to worry about anything except getting on your bike and riding. The guys do your washing afterwards. Accommodation's all organised. Food, it's all great.
Great feeling from security, safe, plenty of service vehicles, fantastic food, SES vehicles, sirens. It's got a real safe, friendly factor about it, which is good to be part of.
Day three of the tour sees the riders enjoying a later start and a hearty breakfast at the Beechworth Bakery in Bendigo. With a considerable gathering of people in the bakery car park, today's leg of the tour starts with really high spirits, and it's obvious everybody is keen to start riding, but not without a few photo opportunities first.
It's going to get warm, so we're going to get it done before it gets too hot.
The local SES escort the convoy through town, ensuring everybody's safe. As the tour leaves the city limits, the pace picks up, and it's obvious today is going to be fast. And although not a race, there are certainly some riders keen to show their ability and speed. Heading north, the back roads offer greater visibility and plenty of flat stretches, giving the riders plenty of opportunity to stretch their legs and work through the gears. Even the locals were keen to see what's going on. After a fast-paced morning, it's time for lunch, and it gives a chance for some of the slower riders to catch up, and everybody refuels with plenty of food on offer. The vibe is positive, and it seems like today we'll see the tour arriving in Echuca possibly sooner than expected.
Yeah, we're moving along at a nice quick pace today. Everyone's working well as a team and it's going really well. We'll be there in no time.
So it's been a really lovely day today, a bit more cruisy, a bit more relaxed, a lot of chatter, banter in the group, but nice rolling turns and yeah, a great day.
I think everyone's got big smiles on their face today. We've been averaging 35 to 40 k's an hour. It's a quick day. Considering the first day was 20 k's an hour, it's really fun. We're pretty well all here, so there must have been about 30 of us in this rolling group. The rolling turns were just awesome. We were just constantly rolling. We had the bakery vehicle in front of us just kicking a nice pace, and it was really fun. We did it. We're here in an hour and a half. Lunch halfway.
You're sensational, Marty.
Ah, thanks,
what a Dad. Great job organising this, eh? Oh, what a legend.
I think it's a big job just driving those old cars. They're bloody hard. He's doing it in bare feet too. I don't know how he does it.
Look, it's all for a good cause.
Yes, I know.
Yes,
he's cheating. He's got thongs on now, but when he's driving his bare feet.
Yeah, got the big toe on the accelerator's doing the job.
He should be hay cutting, but instead he's bloody driving a vintage vehicle.
Like
thanks,
I say,
Dad.
all for a good cause.
Yeah, it is. Thank you.
It has been fantastic. They've created a great environment where there was enough support for the fast guys as well as us slower one-day riders.
It's at this point in the tour that the media crew need to part ways and we say goodbye. But here's a little footage that was taken for the remainder of the tour and the final arrival into Beechworth.
Some of the young guys in 2 years from now, I want to stay with them. In 6 years from now, I want to beat them.
Yeah.
Kick them over.
That's
a pleasure. Give me a hug.
I don't handshake people, no, look. Give me a hug.
Best bout of the week.
There we are.
Well done, guys. We f***ing did it!
Yeah.
you going, Pete? Good to see you.
Sorry.
I bet you would be.
Ah, oh, just for the...
No, it's gone. I'm still eating.
Come on.
Thanks for helping us make it a
champion.
Yeah, no worries.
Okay.
Come over here.
Yeah. This way. Wait.